10 past 8 on Absolute Radio. That was U2 Where the Streets Have No Name. Our special guest this morning, the album came out yesterday, called Keep Calm and Carry On. It's the Stereophonics. Good morning, Kelly.
Good morning.
And Richard.
Good morning.
How are you?
Thank you very much for getting up so early.
That's all right.
I've been looking forward to it all week, haven't you? A nice little early start on Tuesday.
Yeah, it's good. We've got a lot of early mornings this week. They're going to pick around, aren't they?
And you're pleased with the album? It's a cracker. Seriously, it's getting great reviews as well.
No, it's been good, man. We've had a good run with it. We've enjoyed making it. And people are writing about it all right for once.
And what have you been up to this year, then? You've been a lot of live stuff, so obviously recording the album.
Yeah, we did pretty much start making the record in May. We stepped out of the studio to do... We did the Isle of Wight Festival.
Isle of Wight and a couple of warm-ups, yeah.
And did a bit in Camden, did Cardiff Castle.
Yeah.
So, yeah, no, but mainly the tour starts in February. We're going to do the European tour, then in the UK again in March.
And you're still getting the buzz to do the live stuff. Is that still good fun?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what we're about, really, the live thing. So we're going to probably be touring up until September. We go down to Australia, we do Japan, we'll do all the European festivals and stuff, and then probably do a bit in America as well, and then come back the end of September, October, probably.
You must have seen so many changes since you guys started in the band now. The live, obviously live in the festivals now, they're not how they used to be. Like even like Reading and Leeds going back to like the 90s and stuff like that. Now they're big things, aren't they? It's not just Glastonbury. Like say, Isle of Wight is growing. They should be a joke festival. Now every year it's fantastic, the Isle of Wight.
Well, it's about 15 stages in every festival, aren't they?
So, everyone gets to play the main stage, their own main stage.
I know. No, it's good. I think it's good for the punters.
Now, we were just talking about this. You were just looking at Jordan's assets and dropped into the jungle.
Hard to miss, isn't it?
Yeah, it is hard to miss. Yeah, I think if you go on Google Earth, you'll be able to see her right now there, exactly where she is in the jungle. Do you boys bother watching X Factor? You're not into that?
Not religiously. I think, you know, if we're in, we'll have a look. But we're not often home on the weekends. So I have seen it. I did see the one the week before last when Simon kept him in. I thought that was a bit of a funny episode. But that was the main one I saw.
Yeah, because he'd been saying for ages, well, that's it, you know, I'm going to leave the country if they get in there. And I said, OK, well, do you want to keep them out? He went, no. They can't keep the ratings and keep them in. They are odd, aren't they, Jedward?
Yeah.
They kind of seem constantly surprised by each other.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? Considering they've been in the same house all their life.
That's right. They're like two absolute strangers, aren't they? Now, listen, one thing we do when we get bands on, okay, is we do this quiz. So you both can play this, okay? Where we ask bands, we've done this with Chris Martin. We did with Bon Jovi a couple of weeks ago and it tanked. But you guys will do well at this. I'm going to ask you 10 questions. Yeah. And the answers are your own song titles.
Right.
Okay? If a man is caught... What's the high score on this, Richie, by the way? Who did this? Was it Bono got 9 out of 10?
Bono got 9 out of 10, yes. That was with The Edge.
Okay, well, they've got two-man act here. You've got Richard and Kelly here, so they should be okay.
Is that Adam playing, don't they?
Yeah.
who's that out there playing at the moment?
He's our fifth man.
He's the axe wielder.
Yeah, he's been low, though, hasn't he?
Yeah, I was about to. What's he doing? Auditioning? Is he trying to get discovered by Simon Cowell in the background? Okay, if a man is caught turning his head at an attractive woman, he will claim he is.
Just looking.
There you go, Richie, rather done. There's one. What is the stereotypical insincere greeting often given at the end of a conversation with a fast food restaurateur? They bring you food.
Have a nice day.
There you go, Richard. Thank you.
Well done.
When a man has no intention of doing a task for a lady and he's trying to fob her off, when he will tell her it'll be done, what will he say? He'll say, I'll get round to it.
A minute longer? No.
Get round to it.
If I say, Kelly, when are you going to put those shelves up? You'll go, oh...
Maybe tomorrow.
There we go. These boys are no Jedward, but they're pretty good. How many trees make a forest?
Oh, 1,000.
There we go. We're turning now. John Wayne starred in a 1945 Western called what? A lot of people are saying this is one of the best songs of the decade, actually.
Dakota.
There you go.
Yeah.
What will you not find in an Arsenal team photo shoot?
An Englishman?
Almost. He's not a million miles away with it. You're not far. Arsenal, they don't have many English people or locals in the...
Local boy.
There we go. Yeah. Richie, what have they got to go far?
They've got a full house so far. Six.
OK, four more to go and you've beat
good
you two.
Not against the clock, don't
it? In a case concerning the robbery of a pub, who would be the two main characters in the court?
The bartender and the thief.
Get in. When somebody addicted to plastic surgery goes for new surgery, what might the surgeon say to them at their first appointment? Ooh. Plastic surgery.
Plastic.
What's that out there? They might, you know, say, have a look at the catalogue and see something you like. Why don't you
pick apart the
sleeve? Yeah.
Two more ones.
Yeah.
What would you say to someone if you were urging them to get themselves in the queue for an event? Come on, guys.
Hurry up and wait.
Get in, yeah.
This was 8:15 in the night. They reckon it'd be a bit quicker.
Yeah, definitely.
Last one, then, to take the high score and beat you two. If Roger Hargreaves had created a Mr. Man that was a sign writer, what would the story have been called? Richie wrote these. Richie, these are getting worse.
Yeah.
Roger Hargreaves, Mr. Man, create a sign writer. What would the story have been called, Mr.?
Mr. Writer.
Get in!
There you go!
Richard got the bulk of these.
He did,
the superstar there.
Well,
on bass, yeah.
He's always been the most surreal than me.
Richie?
Yeah?
10 out of 10?
10 out of 10, full house.
I'll get on the phone to Bonham.